Hey, I'm Dave.
And I'm Joel.
Let's talk about brains.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
At the fictional Hogwarts School for Witchcraft and Wizardry in the Harry Potter series, students are sorted into different houses by a magic hat based on their personalities. Similarly, in elementary school, a teacher may have declared one side of your brain stronger than the other based on your personality. If you're a creative or artistic type, you would have been identified as right-brained. If you're an analytical or mathematical type, you would have been identified as left-brained.
You might have even used this picture of your brain to choose a college or a career. And while we each have a unique set of talents and abilities, there's no such thing as being right-brained or left-brained.
Not in the way your school teacher explained it to you anyway. And if there were such a thing, almost all of us would be left-brained. The left cerebral hemisphere controls the right side of the body, and about 90% of people prefer to write with their right hand, indicating left brain motor dominance. Moreover, language skills are left-lateralized, or largely controlled by the left hemisphere, in over 90% of people. That includes 78% of people who are not right-handed.
Does this mean that the remaining few with language in the right hemisphere are right-brained? More likely, these individuals have, on average, the same skills and talents as the other 90% of us left-brained folks. The place in the brain where language is localized just happens to be different.
The left cerebral hemisphere is to the right-brained poet or novelist as the hamstrings and quadriceps are to a competitive sprinter. Because the ability to understand and produce language is focused in the left side of the brain in almost everyone, caricaturing these creative types as using their right brain more than their left brain is just plain silly.
Similarly, visual-spatial abilities, which are localized to the right cerebral hemisphere, are skills that are absolutely critical for left-brained talents like science or engineering. The ability to interpret algebraic equations in terms of geometric curves is a specialty of the right brain.
So where did this right-left mythology come from? As we mentioned, some skills are indeed strongly lateralized to one hemisphere of the brain. But much of our obsession with the brain's left and right cerebral hemispheres may have started with studies of split-brain patients in the 50s. During this time, people who suffered multiple seizures a day underwent intense surgery to treat their epilepsy.
To calm the electrical storms that ravaged these patients' brains, the nerve fibers connecting the left and right cerebral hemispheres of the brain were cut. These fibers are collectively known as the corpus callosum. As a once bright highway of information goes quiet, consciousness changes in profound ways, and the specialties of each cerebral hemisphere are more easily disentangled.
Once the corpus callosum is severed on the operating table, the new split-brain patient appears astonishingly normal at first glance. But careful experiments reveal that this person is really two persons, two streams of consciousness in one body. These experiments, performed by Nobel laureate Roger Sperry, found clever ways of feeding information to only one side of the body, and therefore only the cerebral hemisphere controlling that side of the body.
In one experiment, the right hemisphere was shown an image of a snow scene, while the left hemisphere was shown a picture of a chicken. The right hemisphere was instructed to select an image of an object to match the presented scene. After selecting an appropriate object, a snow shovel, the split-brain patient is asked to justify this selection. Remember, only the left hemisphere, which saw the chicken, can speak. Because only the left hemisphere can speak, the patient would give a response such as, "I can use this to shovel out the chicken coop."
So why did the left hemisphere give this answer? Not being able to see the snow scene, the left hemisphere doesn't know that the shovel was selected to shovel snow. Thus, this separate stream of consciousness invents a new reason involving the chicken scene that it can see.
The right hemisphere cannot speak, but it can point to words like yes or no to answer a question. Neurologist V.S. Ramachandran tells a story of a split-brain patient who is asked whether he believes in God. The right hemisphere pointed to yes, while the left hemisphere declared no. Each hemisphere, it seems, maintains independent beliefs and personalities, challenging the notion that we're each an indivisible self.
But this does not justify the pop psychology concept of left-brained or right-brained. The two hemispheres are different, yet brain imaging technologies like functional magnetic resonance imaging, or fMRI, suggest that, on average, we use both sides of our brain equally. We are all brain ambidextrous.
So if there was ever a left-brained or a right-brained person, it would be the two personalities cohabitating the skull of a split-brain patient. For the rest of us, these labels are as fictional as Harry Potter.
Oh, and that thing about only using 10% of your brain, you can throw that one in the garbage too.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe to Professor Dave Explains.
And make sure to check out knowingneurons.com. Brain hemispheres unite.